everybody. Mrs. Mancuso with another Regents Chemistry Review. This one is going to be all about reactions. So the study of reactions is called kinetics. And so we want to look at reaction rates. How can we speed them up? How can we slow them down? Usually we want to speed up reactions and make them happen faster. So let's talk about all the factors. Actually, let's talk about collisions first. That's even a better place to talk about. So collision theory is like, I love to use a high five. So if I effective collision is a high five, what do you need? You need to have your particles at just the right orientation and at just the right speed. So if I'm doing a high five, I have to have my hands just right. If they're a little bit off, it just doesn't make a good high five. Or if it's really slow, that's such a lame high five. So you have to have it just right. Right orientation, right speed. I need my molecules to collide with each other in order to react. So there are six factors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, six factors that can affect the rate of a reaction. So I think one easy way to think of it is like bumper cars. So if you went up to Seabreeze and you went on the bumper car rides and you had like one friend, it would be really lame. So concentration affects reaction rates. The more people you get to go on the bumper cars, the more bumping you're going to have, so the more collisions. So if you increase concentrations, you'll increase the number of collisions. This is definitely something that comes up a lot on the Regents in the part two, and it'll say in terms of collisions. So you got to talk, when you increase concentration, you have more molecules to collide. All right, the next one is temperature. When you increase the temperature, you're increasing the kinetic energy. That means the molecules are going to move faster, and if they're moving faster, they're more likely to hit each other. So more likely to hit each other, that's more collisions. The next one, let's do surface area. So if this is my piece, like let's say this is a piece of magnesium, and I want it to react. The surface area is all the space around the outside. Well, if instead I broke it into all of these little pieces, now the surface of each one of these, all of this is my surface area. So when you powder something or you crush it, you're increasing the surface area. So now you have more exposed area for collisions, and that's why it happens faster. All right, let's talk about pressure. Pressure is only going to affect gases because solids and liquids aren't affected by pressures. They're not compressible. But if you increase the pressure, you decrease the volume. That makes all the molecules closer to each other, which makes them more likely to collide. So if and only if you are dealing with a reactant that is a gas, you could actually speed it up by making the pressure higher so that the molecules are closer and more likely to collide. All right, the next two, catalyst. We often think of like enzymes, but a catalyst could be inorganic as well. So a catalyst is something that you add to a reaction that's going to increase the rate, and it's usually because it provides an alternate pathway, and that alternate pathway requires a lower activation energy. So it makes it easier for the molecules to collide. They are usually unaffected themselves, but they make the rate go up. So for example, enzymes. In the human body, we eat food and we digest our food, and we would digest things naturally, but it would take so long to digest. So instead, we add enzymes and that speeds up the digestion of our food. The last factor is called the nature of the reactant. That means I got to look at what is it that I'm reacting. First of all, the fastest things, you got to have aqueous, and if you can have something ionic, these are going to together make up my fastest reaction. Because aqueous means it's already in water, and ionic means it's going to be pretty easy to dissociate into ions. If I have something that is covalent and nonpolar, it's going to be super slow because it's probably going to be large and it's going to be hard to break it up. So these are the things that will make my reactions go faster. All right, thanks for joining me.